Hey, welcome back to Book Recommendations. Today, I want to talk about The Circle by Dave Eggers. That's the guy up there. And for once, finally, a picture that's actually in colour, because we've now moved into the realm of authors who are still alive. Yay, that's something. The book looks like this, and for ages, I've had this book on my shelves and didn't read it because I didn't like the cover. I feel it looks really boring if I look at the cover. And then hearing about the story, it also didn't appeal to me. But when I finally put myself to reading it, I really, really liked it. And I read the whole book in one weekend. That's how addicted I got to it. Let's go over the basic info first. So the title of the book is The Circle, and the author is Dave Eggers. It was released in 2013. Yes. Actually, most of you were alive already. Actually, all of you were alive when this book was published. Isn't that something? It's quite a long one. It's got 493 pages, but they're small pages, so that helps a little bit, I guess. It was awarded loads of prizes, none of the very big ones, but loads of good other literature prizes. And it's thought to be the new 1984 by many people. So it's actually been quite a hit out there. Which is why I started reading it, because eventually I thought, okay, I should start reading this because it's going to become a new classic. And now that I've read it, I understand why. So what's the book about then? There's the main character, Mae Holland. She gets a new job at a company called The Circle, and The Circle is a big tech company. Kind of reminds you of Google or Microsoft or perhaps Facebook. Because they are trying to invade life in all kinds and of kinds of ways. They are everywhere. They are on all devices. They know everything about you. They're trying to find out even more about you, and they're trying to do recommendations of things on the basis of what they've seen from you. And what they want to do and what they want to achieve is getting out of hand. They want to complete the circle, and that would mean something like, all our lives are out there in the clouds. Everything is there. Mae Holland ends up in that world, ends up finding out about this company. You maybe expect like the stereotypical story, oh, Mae Holland goes there, finds out, tries to solve it. But actually, she gets sucked into the circle. And well, I won't tell you how it ends, but it's not as straightforward as you might think from the cover. The book is obviously commenting on the position of tech companies in this world, and in particular companies like, as I said, Google, Microsoft, and Facebook, and how they're invading privacy, and how about politics seems to be okay with that, and they're actually even using it for their own benefit. It was also made into a film with some rather big names. If you can see, Tom Hanks and Emma Watson were in it. I haven't actually seen it yet, but I've been told that it's quite a good film. So there we go. We get to the recommendation part. So why should you read this book? Well, especially if you're into dystopia. So reading about how the world is not a beautiful place, you have to read this book. If you've got 1984 on your list, definitely read this one as well, because it'll make for a great comparison. There are some really obvious parallels between 1984 and this book. But also if you don't have any of these books on there, I think it's a nice book because it's modern. It's something from life as we know it right now. We are living in this era of the tech companies taking over our privacy, and computer users having to weigh their privacy against the benefits of what tech companies are offering us every single day. So it is kind of our world, I think, and that's kind of nice because most of the books on the list are a bit older and they don't really deal with the world as we see it today. I also thought it was very gripping. The story really sucked me in as I started reading it. I immediately recognized symbolism in there, immediately started recognizing motifs. So that's great for your speaking exam. There are a lot of very obvious and apparent symbols and motifs in this book. But I also quite like the story actually, because it was a very personal story and it wasn't as cold and distant as I had expected from the blurb on the back of the book. So basically, I think it's a really good book, and I think it's also a very suitable book for a speaking exam because it has loads and loads to analyze in it. So yeah, a definite recommendation. And that's all I'm going to say about it. Go out there, grab Dave Eggers and The Circle, and go and read it. See you next time.